Can't you see this guy's crazy?
Can't you see I don't give a shit?
Yeah, I can see that.
Hey, that's better. See there. I knew he'd do it.
I'm just gonna shave you, partner. Take it easy.
Take this, Mitch. Don't move. I don't want you to catch your own throat.
You're not shaving me. You're not coming near me with a razor.
My friend Zachary Oberzan played a small part in my first feature, Home, a romantic comedy shot in my apartment. 2 years later, Zach told me he'd also made a movie shot in an apartment. Since I was still paying off my film, I worried about his finances. And when he told me that his movie, Flooding with Love for the Kid, was an unauthorized adaptation of First Blood, the original novel by David Morrell that introduced John Rambo, I worried about his sanity. To my relief, the film didn't just confirm Zach's mental health, it revealed him as one of the most inventive and driven do-it-yourself filmmakers I've ever had the pleasure to know. Produced for $95.51, Flooding with Love for the Kid is more than a great no-budget indie. It's a reminder that you don't need money to make compelling personal art. You just need skill, guts, and passion. And an understanding landlord. The Sylvester Stallone version of First Blood has one combat boot in the grubby 70s and the other in the triumphalist 80s. Stallone plays Rambo as a strong, silent loner who doesn't go looking for trouble, but finds it anyway. He's a Vietnam vet turned jobless drifter, wandering into a small Pacific Northwest town to visit an old army buddy.
Died last summer.
Died how?
Cancer. Brought it back from there.
You visiting somebody around here?
No.
Mistaken for a hippie by redneck cops, Rambo is more sinned against than sinning. A decent man pushed until he snaps. While both the hero and his antagonist, Sheriff Will Teasel, have a bit more psychological depth than most action film opponents, First Blood is ultimately just a superior action film about a sleeping warrior whose lethal skills are aroused by injustice.
Will, it's Mitch!
In later films, Rambo evolved into a ludicrous and highly politicized character, a right-wing golem single-handedly refighting and winning the Vietnam War. Then carrying the fight to Afghanistan. Then saddling up one last time to clean up Burma. The big screen Rambo is a homicidal teenager, a sullen wallflower who sulks around the edges of life until somebody betrays him, at which point he explodes in rage, unleashing the most spectacular pyrotechnics that Hollywood money can buy. Zach's Rambo is as complex as Stallone's is simplistic, and his movie is more intimate in every sense. Self-mockingly billed as 220 square feet of action, it takes place entirely in Zach's efficiency apartment, with Zach adapting, directing, and editing the movie, and playing every part himself.
walking down the street and you see a little ghost.
What
you gonna do about Ghostbusters?
What is that?
That's the Ghostbusters theme song.
No.
I'm pretty sure it is.
On first glance, Flooding with Love seems part of a minor wave of films in which high-spirited amateurs reenact pop culture touchstones. Rather than mock the characters for indulging in cinematic karaoke, these films cheer their unironic enthusiasm. And they show how artistic expression, whether original or derivative, polished or crude, sheds light on the artist's relationships, neuroses, and desires. Garth Jennings' 2007 film Son of Rambo is that kind of movie, only aimed at kids, a comedy about grade school misfits developing a deep friendship while shooting a homemade sequel to First Blood. When Zach learned of the movie's existence, shortly after he finished editing Flooding with Love, he was understandably freaked out. He needn't have worried, though. While both films are Rambo-centric, their aims are different. Son of Rambo is a lighthearted buddy movie, and the Rambo stuff is just the catalyst for childhood friendship. Flooding with Love, on the other hand, is an outgrowth of Rambo Solo, a one-man off-off-Broadway production by the Manhattan-based Nature Theater of Oklahoma. Zach had been developing it for years and finally premiered it in spring 2009. But where Zach's play was an autobiographical, confessional, experimental work that examined his lifelong fascination with the Rambo character, Flooding with Love for the Kid is a straightforward adaptation of David Morrell's novel, a psychological thriller that owes more to Deliverance than G.I. Joe. Zach sticks to Morrell's portrait of Rambo. He's a hyper-alert, sarcastic young man that looks more like an underfed college protester than an iron-muscled bruiser. And although he's scarred by war, he's still a stupidly prideful man-child with an anti-authoritarian streak that overrules common sense.
What's your name?
None of your goddamn business.
The movie is likewise true to Morrell's depiction of Rambo's foe, Sheriff Teasel, a Korean War vet who feels emasculated by the breakup of his marriage.
Considering what you and I are, I believe I have the right to ask, what were the arguments about?
Kids. I asked her for at least one. It's just that I wanted someone to be to me like I was to you. Certainly surprised me at my age that I wanted one.
The men have more in common than they think, including self-destructive macho pride and a secret wish to return to the battlefield, a place where the prospect of sudden death made them feel alive, and where they at least knew what was expected of them. Like its literary source, Zach's version of First Blood is less a gung-ho adventure tale than a sorrowful drama. Flooding with Love for the Kid may be a glorified home movie, but it achieves goals that the Stallone franchise couldn't or wouldn't pursue. It shows complicated, infuriating people, fighting themselves more than each other, and losing. It's a tragedy of ridiculous men.